I believe that a student who comes to MIT is looking to answer questions that others have not been able to answer. And anyone who's interested in that would greatly benefit from a training that includes a rigorous training in physics as it's being taught here. Physics is a really solid framework on which to understand nature from a very fundamental and mathematical standpoint. The two classes 801 and 802 represents the subject matters of classical mechanics and electricity and magnetism, respectively. So in the first class, 801, students are learning about problem solving based on some things that they have intuition on. It's the everyday world, things that they can see, things that they can experience, and probably when they make a calculation, they make a prediction, they could check and say, this doesn't make sense. I know that when the elevator is going up, and I accelerate, I feel like my weight has gone up, right? So the calculation gives me something that I should be able to check intuitively. Well, by the time they get to 802 in electricity and magnetism, now they're dealing with a mathematical intuition that doesn't always check with what they've experienced in everyday life. Electric fields and magnetic fields are not things that most of us have an intuitive understanding on. The primary lecture is actually so-called TEAL format, technology-enabled active learning. The TEAL format is active, it's interactive, it's learning by doing, but it's also collaborative. You are coming in to engage with the material and engage with the rest of your classmates. It's not your classical lecture where you're sitting and watching the professor. Here, the students are actually doing much of the work. Students are often surprised when I tell them, you know what, I'm going to ask you this problem that you're going to solve. And in fact, I don't want you to memorize the formula. I will give you the physics formula if you want. It's no longer their high school physics. In the high school physics, they've encountered F equals ma. In the physics that they encounter at MIT, well, the subtleties of the acceleration, whether you are in an inertial reference frame or a non-inertial reference frame, now that starts to matter. It's all about the subtleties and really deeply understanding what the physics is teaching you. Those formulas represent a certain underlying truth about nature. And that's what they're really exploring here. People who have studied physics have gone on and done extraordinarily well on many other fields. Some of the greatest numerical solutions in computer science come from framing problems in physics and then taking those complex problems and then putting them mathematically and then realizing that, oh, maybe we don't have the mathematics to actually answer this question, right? So the physics has played its role, which is to take this complex problem and break it down and frame it in a quantitative manner.
Oh, I think it's because this is like sitting.
What I tell my students is that when I'm teaching them how to solve a problem, I'm not teaching them how to solve this specific problem. I'm teaching them an approach to solve any kind of problem.
Oh, whoa!